This is what came in our practice. Six colors, rubber bands, gloves, and instructions. They show different designs and they show you how to do them. We just want to mention that ideally you would like to wear black or clothes that you don't mind getting potentially stained with your tie-dye. And don't forget to put lukewarm water when filling your bottles of dye. Take your elastics and start doing your desired design. We did a bunch of different designs that actually came with the pamphlet. I have to also help Daddy out just because it's his first time actually tie-dyeing, and I've tie-dyed many times before. You will also see a blurred spot. Unfortunately, we had to cover Daddy's bum up. We're done tying up all your elastics with your desired designs. What you do after is start doing your tie-dye. We suggest doing the lighter colors to darker colors. That way, if you accidentally do too much dark, you at least have the chance, if you start with a light, you can cover it or it doesn't seep as much. We also, for some reason, chose not to wear gloves. I never seem to, but I think maybe next time we just may well. But to be honest, at the moment, we've kept our gloves for this pandemic. Now it is time to let it soak. We let it soak on a plastic bag. Also, I should have mentioned this in the beginning, don't forget to, wherever you dye, to put something down. So you don't dye either your kitchen table or your floor or wherever you're doing it. But now you have to let your tie-dye soak. Normally, they say 12 to 24 hours.
The next day.
It is now the next day, so that means it's time to soak and rinse all the dye out. We tried to do it in a little bowl to make sure that the first initial rinse doesn't stain our white bathroom sink. And then we just kind of wrung it out until majority of all of the dye was out and it was mostly clear water. Now it is time to wash all your tie-dye creations. I did add a little bit of our homemade soap into the mix, just to help it out a little bit, and we made sure to wash it on cold. Once it is done in the washer, to put it in the dryer, and then you will get your end results. So we actually had a little bit of tie-dye left over, and we were able to separate the colors for yellow, green, pink, and blue. So now we're gonna do a little science experiment. Once you've done that, you're going to take three pieces of paper towel and roll it lengthways, and then add each end to each of the different colors. Once you're done that, you're gonna wait a couple of minutes to...
A few moments later.
You see the colors start rising up. Obviously, it works better with more pigment colors, but since this was the leftover tie-dye, we figured we would do a little experiment to show our little one what you can do with colors. So we hope you enjoy.